Hello and welcome to Boom Fact Check. On October 15, the passenger of Indigo Airlines, or on Indigo Airlines, and who subsequently got off, was manhandled by ground staff. Though what happened subsequently is something now has been discussed considerably in much detail. The video is also going to play out and you will get a sense of what really happened to that passenger and what actually happened at that airport. So the question, however, we are asking is, in future, as a passenger on an airline or a private airline or a publicly owned airline, are you safe? What is it that you have to be careful of, and is the onus of being safe on you rather than on the airline, in this case, keeping you safe and keeping you protected? So that's the question I'm posing to Jitender, Bhargava, former executive director of Air India, and someone who's also managed the cabin crew portfolio and therefore being in close contact with people who are consumer facing. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Bhargava. So first question, what is the area or what are the kind of situations where someone can physically intervene with passengers of an airline?
At no stage, irrespective of the provocation, should anybody assault a passenger. They should stay away, number one.
Yeah. No, I'm saying there could be a situation where, let's say, there was a cockpit intrusion being attempted.
Look, you can restrain a passenger, but you can't pin him down to the ground or physically assault him.
Okay.
What we witnessed in this episode was unfortunate, deplorable. Mm. Shouldn't have happened. Mm. But let's look at one thing. The situation is, as Indigo's statement said, that the passenger was trying to get under a shade because of the heat. Now that means the only place you have on the tarmac is the aircraft. Mm. Now from the safety security perspective, you're not allowed to get anywhere close to the aircraft. Mm. Now what transpired is still not very clear as to who abused first, or were, because of the sound factor, were the Indigo employees asking him to move away? Mm. And because they may have screamed to draw his attention, he may have think it's been abused, and the thing followed. Number one.
That is,
but the bigger thing is, people have been saying, Indigo employees, and the outrage has been among us. Mm. When people say, I'm not going to patronize Indigo, I think that's not the way to look at it. Mm. Indigo flies millions of passengers. Mm. Are you going to judge an airline by one or two episodes? Mm. The answer is no. Mm. Now, this section of employees, which are ground staff, do not have an interface with the traveling public.
Let me just question you on that, because you know, consumers or passengers in this case are entitled to form an opinion based on events. In the case of United, where a passenger was forcibly removed from the aircraft because he was overbooked, or he had a valid booking, but he was removed. Now the entire price of United fell because people started boycotting the airline.
Let's put it this way. One instance.
No, but it's always one instance. That's my point.
Let's put it this way. What happened was, the way television projected, 81-second video, this is what happened, and everybody playing it repeatedly during the one-hour program that they had.
It's playing right now.
Other part was Indigo's reticence. Mm. Indigo should have reacted earlier. The biggest kind of flaw, in my opinion, from Indigo was that they allowed a free run to the electronic media to play and do it, and panelists, including me, speaking what we felt like in the absence of positive information about Indigo.
Okay.
Like one clear indication was of the failure, humongous monumental blunder, was that the CEO had called the passenger on the day of the incident and personally apologized. Now imagine, A, Indigo did not bring this in the public domain. B, the passenger, while narrating the sequence of events, also did not state at any place.
Okay, so we'll come back to the handling of the issue in a moment, but let's go back to the primary issue, right? The primary issue is, am I safe? And if tomorrow, as I fly from, let's say, Bombay to Delhi, and then I alight from the aircraft, I'm waiting for a bus, something goes wrong, the bus doesn't come on time, it's 45 degrees in the middle of summer, I want to get inside that bus desperately, does the airline have the right to physically push me aside?
First, let's not judge an airline by one instance.
Yeah, whoever.
You are as safe as you were, or you can be anywhere else. Mm.
The question that I'm asking is, am I safe or not safe?
I'm being affirmative.
Yeah.
Yes, you are as safe as anything, number one.
Right.
Don't overlook the fact that if you are a passenger, follow the rules and regulations. Mm. Don't try and get closer to the prohibited area. Mm. And then if somebody
in this case, the passenger wanted to get onto a bus and was, maybe the bus was
that
full.
That was subsequent. Please remember one thing.
Yeah.
If there was no space in the second bus and he was asked to fit third bus, when did it happen? After that, plus his movement towards the aircraft to get into shade. Yeah. This information is in public domain.
Yeah.
Right? Irrefutable.
Yeah.
So the question is, don't get closer to the aircraft, because security and safety is paramount.
No, the moot point is, does the airline or the airline's employees in this case have the right to physically...
They do not.
Yeah, that's my question.
They have transgressed their right.
Yeah.
Now, as I said earlier, these people who handle the ramp and all those kind of things do not have a natural interface with passengers. Mm-hmm. Airlines do not invest money in making them sensitive towards passengers. The concentration is toward check-in passengers, cabin crew, pilots to some extent. Right? Now, question is, they behaved in this manner which they should not have. On this, there is total unanimity that these employees, A, should not have done what they did. B, Indigo has been soft in dealing with them. There should have been very, very harsh action. And compounding all this was their silence. They should have come forth and explained as to what exactly happened, considering the fact that the video surfaced 3 weeks after the incident had taken place.
Correct. And the incidents happened on October 15th. So you're saying that airlines by nature, and going by your own experience as well, are inclined to train, let's say, cabin crew, check-in staff, and
Anybody who has a customer, baggage delivery staff.
Yeah, or train or whatever. Make them sensitive about consumer-facing issues. Otherwise, the rest of the airline is really not concerned about what the consumer is thinking, feeling, going through, suffering, and so on.
No, not suffering kind. Every airline will have, every employee will have the onus to ensure that they give good service, because they are a good part of the chain that you have a service. But they don't have a personal interaction with the employees. So the etiquettes and all those kind of things.
So I'm trying. If I were to flip that around, I could say that as a passenger, I should not therefore expect ultra sensitivity on any issue.
But you're not interacting with them. You don't get to.
But I might. Let's say I might encounter a loader because you know my bag is gone somewhere.
Airline, in their wisdom, have looked at the areas where there's going to be a personal interface with the passengers, and therefore they train those employees. Here was a ramp person taking care of cargo loading, and I think they have nothing to do with it. But yes, the fault I would say is there is a supervisor on the tarmac who overlooks transportation of passengers in a coach. Now, he should have been the person who should have been intervening at that stage and defuse the situation, which did not happen. Possibly that man wasn't there at that time. But I'll repeat again, traveling by air is as safe as it can be.
Now, we're not talking about airline safety. We're talking about safety from the people who run airlines or work in airlines.
You see the kind of jokes that surface, etc., soon after this incident. In bad taste, in my opinion. You do not, okay, it's humor. One can set aside this thing. But please do not accentuate or perpetuate these kind of things that because such a thing happened to one passenger, that I will think twice before traveling. No, I'll consider continue to travel and believe in the airline that yes, I'm safe because the systems are there.
So let me put a slightly different question to you. Because of the stress that we are seeing in the system, stress I mean the number of aircraft, the number of flights, the number of limited people. Indigo is one of those airlines which has been trying to do more with less resources or similar resources as before. So all of this puts a lot of pressure on staff.
Undoubtedly.
Right? So,
so
to that extent,
three factors. A, up employees being overworked, one. Number two, in the wake of the kind of stressful environment in the work, is the training curriculum needs a review. In my opinion, yes. Like, for example, after this instance, there is no harm in saying, spending a day of training, imparting them to even these staff who do not normally have a customer interface. Because one aberration, look at the kind of hit on the image of Indigo that they have faced. Now, they wouldn't have visualized the scenario. But coming back to it again, Indigo is guilty of not handling. One is mishandling of passenger. Second is not handling
of the situation
efficiently, proactively.
No, but you agree with me, therefore, that not just Indigo, maybe other airlines too, are operating in extremely stressed environments. And therefore, we could see some sort of flare out.
A few things here. A, the industry has growing is growing at 20% plus, we know about it. You can't get that many staffers and train them. You're not doing it. Third factor, which is more critical here, is when we look at these situations here, now you are, because of your financial state that all airlines went through, haven't been inducting as many people. The staff costs have been going down because the ATF prices were high. Now, you, the airlines will have to relook at the whole business model and say, look, if customer safety and comfort of travel is paramount, we got to invest in those areas. Now, that's something perhaps would need a review, and each airline would need.
So, therefore, you are agreeing with me that we are in a situation today where the likelihood of similar flare-ups again happening again is high.
I would put it on a very, very remote kind of a chance. I again repeat, it's an aberration that took place here. And it went viral because Indigo did not react. So people formed a certain perception. Hmm. It could have been nipped in the bud if CEO had come out and said, look, a press conference, right? Hmm. That this is what happened on that day. Hmm. We apologize as they did in the statement. Hmm. It should not have happened. Hmm. We are reassuring the traveling public that our staff will not be indulging in these kind of things because we've taken exemplary action. Mm. Here is, we were even critical of the kind of action that took place.
Right.
People believed that action was too soft, and the two employees concerned, one was of course dismissed, the third one, but the two employees concerned were suspended for a very short period. Mm. Now you don't have to do it. And third thing again Indigo faltered was, they say in their statement, that the man who's been terminated or who was being projected as a whistleblower by the media was the guy who said, "Isko bus mein mat jaane do." Now, if he was an instigator, Indigo ought to have come forward and said, "Look, our action is right." Because I saw television channels kind of a thing painting Indigo in bad light and said, "This guy must be reinstated," including the statement by the Minister of State for Civil Aviation, Jan Sena. Right. He tweeted this thing that I will meet all sides and see how can I address his concern.
Right. So, I mean, let me not go too deep into this because that's something that most people have read or seen about. No, let me come back to the more fundamental question, right? So, we're talking about how safe am I when I travel. So, you've talked about things from an airline's perspective. You said under no condition is an airline employee entitled to assault someone.
Absolutely.
Right? So, that's very clear. Now, we are also acknowledging the fact that we are operating and will operate in very stressed environments because of sheer physical pressure, the number of flights, aircraft, now less people,
financial constraints,
all of that, right? In such a situation, how do I, as a passenger who, let's say, flies frequently or flies occasionally, be more careful and protect my interests in going forward? If I were to encounter a situation, I want to get into a bus desperately because maybe it's 45 degrees in the middle of summer in Delhi and I'm feeling uncomfortable, I'm not well. So what do I do then? I mean, if I find the airline being unfriendly or not accommodating my request.
No, it's basically having a relook at the standing operating procedures. We know the heat element in Delhi, right? How many coaches, or can I put a coach at a standby? So the moment a plane is chalked off.
Yeah. So from a flip side, I should therefore expect that.
No. Huh. It's for the airline. Please, let me explain to you. Yeah. Passengers should not be bothered about it. Mm. The onus is on the airlines to ensure that passengers are safe. They feel safe, that is. Mm. So, like, for example, why should a passenger be made to wait for a coach? Mm. Let coach be waiting for it. Mm. Which means you do not have adequate number of coach. Commensurate
with the
kind
of growth rate.
Commensurate with the growth rate that you're going through it.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. So, airlines, the onus is on the airlines to look at it. But as coming back to it again, one episode should not lead to some passenger thinking that I am going to be unsafe while traveling. Mm-hmm. These kind of things, once in a blue moon kind of a thing, happens in all countries. Mm. As I said here, we have given far more prominence to this instance because it was on video. Mm. Had somebody told me or narrated this instance without the backing of the visual images, I wouldn't have believed that an airline employee can assault a passenger. Mm. Such things don't happen.
But that's precisely the point, isn't it?
That's what I'm saying. You see, you've had plentiful of instances of acrimonious fight at the airport, rude behavior on behalf of this thing. But then coming to the one important thing is, people have been talking about no-fly list on one side and said, what are you going to do to an airline? Mm. Now, you don't react in that manner. No-fly list is a totally different thing. Mm. Here is, people are not privy to the information, the number of employees who get dismissed, suspended, or get punished when a passenger complains and we find the complaint to be genuine. Mm.
Has this happened in your
tenure? Oh, plentiful of cases. There have been instances of kind of thing where we have demoted people, where we have suspended people. Of course, Air India being a government airline, we couldn't have gone to the extreme. Mm. But in a private airline, they can lose the job. Like in this case of the perceived whistleblower whose services have been terminated. Mm.
Right. So, if I mean, as we wind up now, so you know, if we were to look ahead, is it likely that one, like I said, just to ask you the same question again, something adverse could happen to me in a high pressure situation? That's number one. Number two, if it happens, what do I do as a flyer? Number three, how do I choose an airline where perhaps my safety or my perception of safety is higher than compared to other airlines?
You see, all airlines are safe. Let me explain to you.
Mm. No, we're not talking about technical safety.
I'm about safety and security. I'm talking using both the words. Mm. The fact is, travel as you have been traveling. Mm. Should you encounter any kind of a place where you are being held up or you are being told not to do this, just follow that. You have reasons to complain to the chief executive of the airline. You can tweet, you can put on Facebook, social media and say, look, this is what happened to me. But why get into an argument with a staffer whose education level may not be much, who has not been trained to understand the passenger sensitivities, etc. So all that thing is there, but final word would be reassuring that please travel and feel free as far as safety and security is concerned.
So, absolutely, last question. So this is one part of it where we are talking about somewhat physical situations where there could be encounters. In many cases, and in many airlines, passengers encounter indifference, rude staff, you know, where you may be provoked to do things, and some people also do things, including it's happened in the case of Indigo. But how do I, as a passenger, what do I do? I mean, this is a very general question. When I'm very upset with the quality of service,
appointing an ombudsman. What government put out the draft in public domain was airline centric. Now there could be provocations from the staff, etc., and you get into it. And because you have fought or you have delayed a flight does not mean that you get on the no-fly list. That's why we said many of the stakeholders have suggested that when an ombudsman this thing, it should not be immediate action as far as the no-fly list is concerned. There should be an opportunity given. Take, for example, the Air Passengers Association of India. Get the representative on it. They will take up the case of the passenger and say, this is what happened. This was the kind of provocation. Now, imagine what a passenger does.
So you're saying
you
may
be traveling because of your, say, a tragedy in the family. Then maybe you can't afford a delay in a flight because there's a funeral to be attended. Now you're going to react differently. So when an airline has to look at all this, it must take care of the physical state of a passenger. Don't aggravate it. Be kind. And as we say in the service industry, you can't be rash, rude, etc. You got to be polite. If hotels can do it on ground, there's no reason why airlines cannot. And they have been doing it. Let's put it this way.
So we've run out of time. Thank you very much, Mr. Bhargava, for joining us and throwing some light on this very important issue. And the question that we were asking as we started out was, are you safe while traveling? Mr. Bhargava says that you are safe and this was a one-off incident that you shouldn't pay that much attention or heed to, but hopefully you will form your own decision. Thanks for watching.